Dave Ferraro with Search Amelia. We're at the Palace in downtown Fernandina Beach. I'm talking with Christopher Rex. He's with the Chamber Music Festival. Hi, Christopher.
Hi, how are you?
Tell us a little bit about your organization, the shows.
Well, I'm the artistic director of the Amelia Island Chamber Music Festival, and we're really excited. We're kicking off our eighth season now, and I tonight at the Palace with a really fabulous lineup of artists this summer. We start off with Robert McDuffie, a great solo concert violinist. And in this setting, that's a wonderful thing about this festival, is we have many different concerts in a variety of settings. Churches tonight's at the Palace Saloon, the oldest saloon in Florida, and it's a lot of fun. We try to take the stuffiness out of chamber music and make it very accessible to a variety of demographics. So we have the beer tasting series here. That's the beer tasting series, which has serious music, but done in a way that's a lot of fun. And then we have the various local churches. We'll have the seats on wonderful Russian fans who come back and do their music under the Tsar, a Russian program with Maria Bachman, who is a chamber music musician, is very well known over the whole country. And we'll have the Juilliard String Quartet is coming, making one of their final performances with their current first violinist, their chamber violinist. And in addition, in October, actually, which is an extension of the festival, the Guarneri String Quartet will be their final performance before they disband here at the festival. But we run for the next 3 weeks, we'll have about 16 concerts. When the courthouse will have it open to the public this Sunday in Central Park of late classical string quartet music. And we'll have Arnold Starkheart and the Guarneri Quartet will come and do a wonderful program of Joseph Haydn. And it's an anniversary season of both Haydn and Mendelssohn. So we'll be doing a lot of Haydn and Mendelssohn. Cellist Andre Diaz, Lincoln Center chamber player, pianist Anne-Marie McDermott will be here, and Akiko Myers. So we just had a lot of great, great artists, plus sort of standard core that we have, trio, RPM, and myself. We're very excited, and it's actually a great season.
That sounds like some quality music and some quality musicians. And I noticed tonight you have a packed house. Is that, you experience packed houses?
We're selling quite well. Good. We're also doing a very interesting concert out of Fort Clinch. It's a Stravinsky piece called A Soldier's Tale. So I thought it was appropriate to do it at the fort. And it's for a small group narrator, and we're having some mime masked dancers in conjunction with that. So that should be very special. In addition, there's a candlelight concert with flute, soprano, and harp, but that already is sold out. So that's also important. And then we'll have our final gala, ending gala, at the Ritz-Carlton Hotel. Still tickets available with the Aurora Trio, a really dynamic young female trio that was called Night at the Opera, No Singers.
That sounds wonderful. I recommend that you visit and go to one of these events. It's high quality entertainment for low cost here on the islands, local. Thank you very much, Mr. Rex.
I hope to see you in September.
I'll be there.